China to donate more COVID-19 vaccines to the Philippines. This was announced by Chinese Ambassador Huang Qilian in a post on social media. He says Beijing will send 1 million more Sinovac vaccines to Manila next week. That's in a bid to help boost the country's inoculation drive. Chinese-made COVID-19 vaccines make up almost half of the Philippines' supply. Philippine Health Secretary Francisco Duque III questions government's decision to remove the facility-based quarantine for fully vaccinated travelers. See, on Wednesday, Malacañang announced those fully vaccinated from so-called green countries are no longer required to undergo such a procedure. But Duque says he wasn't consulted about the matter.
As far as I'm concerned, I've always supported a facility quarantine. At least, 5 days test, and then once the result comes out, you continue home quarantine.
At home.
If I recall, even the president had said that he wanted to just reduce the quarantine period, but not to get rid, do away with the quarantine period. I was told that in some countries they're doing this now, but those countries can afford to do it because their national vaccination coverage is more than 70%, whereas we are only at 30%. And not all travelers are going passing through NCR. Some travelers are going to Davao, to Cebu, to other airports. So that's a cause for concern.
Duque also says other officials like Vaccine Chief Carlito Galvez Jr. and Interior Secretary Eduardo Año were also not part of the deliberations. Duque says he will raise his concerns over the new policy during the meeting of the Interagency Task Force on COVID-19 today. Well, the issue over easing health restrictions for travelers comes as the National Capital Region shifts to a looser quarantine alert level this weekend. Metro Manila will be under alert level 3 from October 16 to 31. The NCR has been under alert level 4 since mid-September. Under alert level 3, more businesses will be allowed to reopen at increased capacities. But a group of doctors warns this may lead to another surge in COVID-19 cases.
We can actually expect na medyo aakyat uli ang number of cases. Mm-hmm. We need to take calculated risk. Pero the important word or the important term is calculated. They don't even know kung ano yung dapat na maging basehan, no? How much decrease in the cases, how much ano yung utilization rate ng mga ospital ang gusto nilang tignan. Pag umabot ba sa ganito o pwede na, no? Mm-hmm. Tapos pag nakita nilang umaakyat, ito naman ang aming gagawin. Is there such a thing?
Government also approved a modified enhanced community quarantine status for 11 areas outside of Metro Manila, including Bulacan, Cavite, and Zamboanga City. Areas to be placed under a general community quarantine with heightened restrictions include Baguio and Bacolod. Dozens of other areas, such as the province of Cebu and Davao City, will be under GCQ. The rest of the country will be under modified GCQ. Cinemas in Metro Manila can finally reopen this Saturday as it shifts to alert level 3. But Interior Secretary Jonathan Malaya says, make that undersecretary, the places can only cater to fully vaccinated individuals and at a limited capacity.
A lot of people are so happy with this. No? Even the Cinema Operators Association, they're happy because under the old guidelines, they would still continue to be prohibited under alert level 3. But they really appealed and requested that they be allowed to open. So yes, 30% indoor capacity for cinemas under alert level 3. Since it's only 30%, there will be seats in between moviegoers that will be left vacant.
Aside from the downtrend in daily COVID cases, Malaya also credits the ramped up vaccination drive for the easing of the restrictions in Metro Manila.